In this video, you're going to learn how to use variables when creating agents in Google Workspace Studio. To understand what variables are, let's have a look at something many of us are familiar with. When you use a document template, let's say for a business letter, it usually comes with placeholders for you to add the necessary information. For this letter, it's clear to us that we have to replace your company with our company's name. And the same is true for 123 Your Street, and so on. The same principle is true for variables in Workspace Studio, as they are placeholders for information from starters and previous steps that can be used to pass information to later steps and hence make our agent dynamic. For example, you can use a variable to insert the subject line of an email from your starter into a Google Chat message step. Let's see how you can add variables to your agents. On screen, we have an agent to help a manager track travel expense requests from their team. They have a Google form set up for their team members to submit when they have a business travel request, and then it sends a custom email notification when a new submission is made. We can use variables in the message field. These variables allow us to add information from the starter, like the form submitter, when the form was submitted, the response itself, and more. We can either select the variable from the drop-down list after clicking the Variables button, or we can use the Add Keyboard shortcut for a list of all available variables to appear in line. Some fields accept only certain types of data. That is why in the agent you see on screen, the To field for the step Send an Email only accepts the Form Submitter variable from the starter, since the information has to be an email address. This can mean that in some cases you might see that no variables are available because the previous steps don't have that data. Sometimes steps may not have all the variables you want. For example, perhaps you want to know if your team members are traveling for conferences. We can add a step that leverages AI to extract more specific pieces of information. We'll add this step and extract extra details from the form response, and then plug those details into the message. When configuring the Extract AI Skills step, we can create variables that contain the outcome of a search for custom data. Let's have Gemini look over the form response, and then below we can define some custom information we want to extract. We have defined two variables, conference name and business justification. And for each, we have told Gemini how to perform the search in the description field. In subsequent steps, we can use these variables to gain access to the extracted information. Since variables contain information of the starter and previous steps, changing the order of the agent's steps can have an impact on its variables. As you can see on screen, we moved the Notify Me in Chat step to run before the Extract step, even though it needs the content generated by Gemini. This agent can't be turned on as is. To fix this, we simply move the Notify Me in Chat step to run after the Extract step. As we've seen, variables are very powerful, especially when you combine them with AI agents and skills. Want to learn more about Workspace Studio? Then check out more resources and documentation linked in the description of this video. Also, subscribe to this YouTube channel for more such tutorial videos.